Hey, what's up guys? Welcome back to Dr. Says. In this video, I'll tell you what are the common side effects of Diamicron MR and why you should be careful if you are taking it. If you miss out on my video where I talk about macrovascular and microvascular complications of diabetes, you can click on the link above. Now, let's get on to it. First and foremost, you should know that Diamicron is a brand name. The generic name or drug name is called Gliclazide, and it actually belongs to a group of drugs called sulfonylureas, which is a common group of drugs doctors use to treat diabetes. Diamicron MR, also known as Gliclazide MR, comes in two formulations, 30mg and 60mg. MR stands for modified release, which means the drug will be slowly released into your body over time. That is why the dosing is always OD, also known as once a day, whereby an older version of the drug without MR needs BD dosage or twice a day. A little bit on how it works before we move on to the side effects. How Diamicron works is it stimulates insulin from the pancreas and reduces glucose output from the liver, hence reducing your blood sugar. Now, what are the common side effects? Number one, hypoglycemia or low blood sugar levels. In fact, this is the number one side effect of any sulfonylurea drugs. Hypoglycemia is more likely to occur when the patient is unwell and is not tolerating orally well after a prolonged exercise or when alcohol is co-ingested. It is also more likely to happen in elderly patients, malnourished or debilitated patients. If one is taking concomitant beta blockers together with Diamicron, it may impair the patient's ability to recognize the signs and symptoms of hypoglycemia. Number 2, allergy. As the name suggests, sulfonamides contain sulfur, and sulfur is one of the common elements to cause allergy in humans, from mild skin rash to urticaria, angioedema, to more severe complications like bullous formation. A rare yet fatal side effect for all sulfur-containing drugs is Stevens-Johnson syndrome. This condition consists of painful and blistering lesions on the skin and mucous membrane, including the mouth, throat, eyes, and genital region. If not treated urgently, it is life-threatening. Therefore, if you guys are recently started on this drug, be aware of your skin changes and report to your treating physician immediately if you notice any skin changes. Number 3, cardiovascular side effects. Some studies have found that patients who have underlying heart disease on Diamicron may be associated with increased cardiovascular mortality. What this means in layman language is, if you have a heart disease and you are on Diamicron, your risk of dying due to heart disease is higher as compared to those who are diabetic and treated with other medications. But before you guys start throwing away all the Diamicrons, take this with a pinch of salt because some other studies show conflicting results. Do note, however, the American Diabetes Association and Diabetes Canada do suggest other agents are preferred to Diamicron, especially those patients with established cardiovascular disease. Now, what are the contraindications of Diamicron? Number 1, if you're allergic to sulfur-containing drugs. Examples of sulfur-containing drugs besides sulfonylureas are some common antibiotics like Bactrim, some NSAIDs or non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drug like Celebrex. Another common drug is sulfasalazine that is commonly used to treat Crohn's disease or ulcerative colitis. Number 2, if you have severe renal impairment or poor kidney function. This is because 60 to 70% of this drug is excreted via your urine. If one has renal impairment, it prevents this drug from excreting out of your body, hence increasing your risk of developing hypoglycemia. Number 3, if you have severe hepatic impairment like liver cirrhosis or failure, it is because Diamicron is metabolized or being processed in your liver. If one has liver failure and unable to process this drug, it will again increase your risk of hypoglycemia. Number 4, G6PD deficiency. Patients with G6PD deficiency may be at increased risk of sulfonylurea-induced hemolytic anemia, which means your red blood cells breaking down. If possible, patients with G6PD should avoid taking this drug. Number 5, if you are pregnant or trying to become pregnant, Diamicron may affect your developing baby if you take it during pregnancy. Number 6, if you have type 1 diabetes mellitus. This is obvious because the causes of type 1 and type 2 diabetes are totally different. Therefore, the treatment is also different. If you missed my previous video where I talk more about the difference between type 1 and type 2, you can click on the link above. So this is it, guys. Stay safe, stay healthy, and don't forget to click like, share, and subscribe if you want to see more content like this in the future.